Did you know that geometric characteristic symbols are applied at default conditions, and there is a rule which talks about this condition in geometric dimensioning and tolerancing? Hi, I am Palani Kailash, a designer by profession and trainer by passion, who would love to create a difference in your career life. Hit the subscribe button and bell icon to get more notification on all my videos, which would help you in developing your skills. You can download this presentation from the link given in the description. Let's get started now. Rule 2, regardless of feature of size, applies with respect to the individual tolerance, and regardless of material boundary, applies with respect to the individual datum reference feature reference where no modifier symbol is specified. Here, this is the geometrical tolerance where there is no modifier symbol, which is called as default condition. And we have three datum references and we don't have any modifier symbols in this references also. So this is also a default condition. So when there are no modifier symbol in either the tolerance segment of the feature control frame or the datum segment of the feature control frame, then it is called regardless of feature of size and regardless of material boundary, which is the default condition, which is stated in rule number 2. So here is an example. We have a feature of size and the positional tolerance. For the positional tolerance, there is no modifier, and for the datums, there is no modifier. So this is a default condition where regardless of feature of size applies. Whenever we have a regardless of feature of size, then we have tighter tolerance. In this case, the hole can be produced anywhere between 11.9 to 12.1, but the positional tolerance value of diameter 0.1 remains constant. In most of the general engineering applications like jigs, fixtures, gauges, machine tools, machineries, we require tighter tolerance. In all such cases, we go with regardless of feature of size. Wherever it is necessary, we can use maximum material condition modifier or least material condition modifier in the geometrical tolerance value, along provided the feature control frame is applied to the feature of size, and maximum material boundary or least material boundary modifier may be applied to the datum reference of the feature control frame. So here we have an example of maximum material condition applied to a tolerance and maximum material boundary applied to a datum reference. Similarly, we have a least material condition applied to a tolerance, least material boundary applied to a datum. We take one example on maximum material condition. So here we have some flexibility. This maximum material condition applied to diameter 0.1 for positional tolerance tells that only when the hole is produced at its maximum material condition, in this case 11.9, positional tolerance of diameter 0.1 holds good. When the hole departs from maximum material condition of 11.9 to least material condition of 12.1, then the positional tolerance value changes from 0.1 increases to 0.3. Wherever you have to ensure assembly and wherever you have to reduce the scrap rate, in all such applications, we go with maximum material condition modifier. Usually in most of the automobile parts, you find maximum material condition modifier. This example is about using least material condition modifier. So here, when the hole is produced at its least material condition of 12.1, then the positional tolerance is diameter 0.1. When the hole departs from 12.1 and moves towards maximum material condition of 11.9, then the positional tolerance increases from 0.1 to 0.3. Most of the applications where we have to ensure minimum wall thickness on a part, in such applications we use least material condition modifier. Aeronautical applications and other critical precise applications where material thickness is very important. In all such cases, we use least material condition modifier. In this presentation, I have used three new terminologies: RMB, MMB, and LMB. So I just briefly explain what it is in the coming slides. So whenever there is a datum reference, and if that datum reference is a feature of size, and if there is no modifier symbol, then we call it as regardless of material boundary, RMB. Whenever the datum reference is a feature of size and it is having a maximum material modifier, then we call it as maximum material boundary, MMB. Whenever there is a datum reference which is a feature of size with the least material modifier, then we call this as least material boundary, LMB. When MMC or LMC modifier is applied in the tolerance segment of the feature control frame, and MMB or LMB modifier is applied in the datum reference segment of the feature control frame, then we are overriding rule 2, which means there that we are coming out of default condition of the geometrical tolerances and we are having flexibility. This is all about rule 2. Hope you got adequate information in this video. Like this video and share it with your friends. See you soon with another video.